Hey everyone, welcome back to Soul Reaver Part 5. I am Izzy Noodles, and the story so far is that we have defeated the brothers Melchiah, Zephon, and Rahab, and the next brother would be Duma. But I said last time that this video won't have any story. It's only going to be collecting the glyphs and the upgrades. So, firstly, I have walked to Melchiah's territory. That's where I left off last time. And there's two ways out of here. You don't want the stairs that leads to where we don't want to be, so come to the side that has the door. Okay. So you might recognize where we are. If I just turn the angle, you'll see the blocks there. So we climbed up there to defeat Melchiah. And from here, we're gonna get a piece of pie. Whoops, I fell. Bad start already. So don't forget, after defeating Rahab, we can now go into the water. That won't harm us now. Okay, so there's this ladder here that has a piece of pie at the top. There we go. So we got the climb ability from Zephon. So from here you want to take a left and just basically go across to the other side of the water. Hop up. We have been in here before, but this time we're going to collect some stuff that we couldn't collect before. And you do want your Reaver, so just be careful of the enemies. You come to this box. It's got, whoop, this guy. It's got images of the Reaver on it. So you want to interact with that. I sort of sped that up a bit because that guy was sneaking up behind me. Rude. So that does stuff and you just want to hop inside. Follow it down, you'll have another doorway, so you still want your Reaver. So anything with a Reaver on it like that, you are most likely going to be able to interact with it. Okie dokie. So I've seen somewhere on the internet some deleted images of this doorway. I mean, you can't interact with this now, but I believe that is a deleted area, like a shortcut to somewhere else. But I don't know. I don't really know. But anyway, behind this, we have an energy upgrade, power up. So that's increased our energy. You see in the top left corner, we now have 18 sparklies. So now we have that. We can just hop out the same way we hopped in. Oh, my image is kind of dark. I don't know why it's so dark. It shouldn't be. Anyway, come back through the gate we entered. And the next item to collect is a glyph, so just hop straight into the water. And right here in this corner is a passage. So we are going to get the stone glyph, and it can be annoying to get two. So not this part, the swimming's easy. Okay, so don't forget these Melchiah, or however you pronounce them, they can bury themselves and come out of the ground, so just be aware of that. That's kind of annoying. So, random cutscene for no particular reason. And you're just hopping straight into the eyeball. Follow the passage, there are enemies, but I usually just ignore them. Because I want to hold on to the Reaver. Because the Reaver is awesome. But if you do end up fighting and you lose your Reaver, you can just pick the guys up and throw them onto the things with fire on the wall because they've got spikes on them. And there is a guy up here who I probably will shoot. No, he disappeared too soon. I'm coming over to this spiky thing. So he's... Oh, there he is. Rude. Oh, why are there two of them? Well, do your best. Whoops. I don't want to lose too much health, because then I can get it back and get my Reaver back. Okay, oh, is this the same guy? Shoo. Okay, better get my Reaver. There we go. Even though it does not matter, because I'm going to shift very shortly anyway. But anyway, you want to come up to here. And basically, we're heading upwards. So, next, hop onto this ledge here. And now we're aiming for that beam right above Raziel's head. Excuse me, very croaky. But you can't reach that in the material realm. I've seen someone do it, but I cannot do it. It's just impossible. So the intention is to shift, and then everything's gonna move about. Now it's slightly closer. Still a little tedious to reach. You want to crouch down and do your jump. And there we go. And so you don't fall off, you want to sneak along. Sneaky. Because you don't want to fall. Falling is not what we want to do. Okay, so next beam and then to the portal so that we can shift. Okay, so the beam that I was just on is now higher, so I'm gonna hop back onto that. Okay. And the next beam, straight above. There we go. So now I've come to the end and up the steps. I am not a confident person with small ledges, which is why I'm sneaking around so much. There's nothing wrong with being cautious. So then you just need to hop up to here, and we've no more sneaky ledges left, so that's good. Follow the path. I believe there are still a couple of enemies. Not many here. There's one. Okay. So this guy, you can just shoot him off the edge. Cool. So just gently hop up here, because you don't want to jump all the way over. So we're on top of the skull now. If you fall down, you will not take damage, because Raziel does not take damage from fire or from high up. From falling, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. He does not take damage from falling, but you will have to climb all the way back up. So I'm going into that cave for the glyph, but I'm just going to point out you can get over there as well. So there's a health piece over there, but I will come back to that once I've got the glyph. So following the path. And here we are. So we've got a block puzzle, and as soon as we come in, there is a block up here that has been sneakily hidden. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm just going to put this where it should be and give it a shove off the edge. And just try and grab it and take it into the room where it should be. Okay, so this particular block goes on the right hand side, so I'm just gonna flip it so it's the right way round. Let's see the picture. There it is. That's perfect. So just line it up. And push it straight in. And you know it's in because you can hear it click. So if you put the wrong block in the wrong place, then it does not click into place. So this block right in the corner where I've just put that other one, this goes on the opposite side. So where's the image? There it is. So I'm just going to flip it this way once. And this way. Okay, and just push it straight forward. Cool. So now we can go up to the next level. There's only two levels. There's not like a million billion, so it's not too difficult. So there's this side and there is the other side as well. And they both lead into this back room. So the blocks we need are in this room. So there's that block just hanging up there. So let's get that down. We actually need to use a couple of blocks to get that. So the first thing you're better off doing is using the blocks you have access to instead of already placing them. So you're just lining them up in a row so that you can get to that other block. So now you can pull this out once, get behind it, and just shove it until it falls off. Super duper. And one block up here. So just give that a shove. Okay, so now we have all the blocks we need, except this one, where there is no image on any side of this block. That's just kind of a troll block or a helper block to get to the block that was on the top. So we do not need that one. So let's have a look and see what we need. Come to this further one. Oh, I forgot there is a block here. So that's got a face missing, facing to the left. So let's have a look. My image is very dark and I don't know why. I'm struggling to see this. So I believe it might go here, but I could be wrong. We will soon find out. Listen for the click. There we go, that's good. Whoops. Oh, let's look at the other one. Well, I can barely see that. Why can't I see it though? Just gonna have to guess. I'm going to go with this one. So you need this open space so that you can actually flip the box and move them, because you can't do that in the little areas, what are they called? The thinner passages. It's not even a passage. I don't know. Okay, next I'll use this one. Okay, so with this one, you want to make sure that, because it's a circular sort of image, but it's got lines you see at the top of Raziel's head, just going off the block. So that needs to be that way round. Okay, so this is the last block. Cool. So now, just go and claim our stone glyph. Okay, so as usual, I will give a demonstration. I mean, it's not the same without the enemies, but I'll just show it off anyway. So that actually petrifies enemies just for a moment so that you have a chance to attack them. Don't forget, after you get a glyph, you always get the eyeball image on the ground, and that puts your energy all the way back up. So now, I'm going to go and get that health piece. So firstly, let me just climb these steps. If you have a look, you've got a bullseye just there to the right, so I'm just going to hit that. And if you hit it but nothing happens, you're just too far over. Because that is a block and you want to push it into the wall. There we go, because that's at the top of a ladder. And you can't actually climb the ladder with that block hanging out. So let's go to the ladder. So you have to go to the ladder in order to actually be able to get to there. And then I hop up and hop up again. So when we get our next piece of pie, we will complete the pie and we'll get the health upgrade. So from here, you might not be able to see very well, it's a bit foggy, but hopping straight down leads to a warp gate. So just, there we go, straight on down to the warp gate. So you are able to just ignore the warp gate and just fall straight back down to the ground. You will not be harmed. So activate this, and I'm going to use this. So I am now going to the Zephon's Lair warp gate. Not the one inside the lair, but the one outside. Here we go. So as we come out, you've got the humans, and if you don't attack them, they bow to you. And if you need health, you can just hold down the feed button next to them and you will drain their energy without killing them. So that's awesome. So here we are. From here, we are just heading to the tiny set of pillars. I don't like to call them the pillars because there are the pillars of the main storyline. But these are not the ones that I mean. So you'll see what I mean when we get there. So just shift to come through the gates. And it's these little pillars where we started, where we found our first portal. And you want to climb this ladder here, and this is our health piece that gives us the upgrade. Awesome. So even though we have already been to this area, we could not pick up the health piece before defeating Zephon. It does not matter what order you get all these upgrades in, as long as you've got the abilities. You need to get the abilities after defeating the brothers or whoever. But then you can just come back to anywhere at any time. Awesome. So now I just need to shift back to the material realm. So just come all the way over into the corner to the portal. Unfortunately, it's all the way out of the way. Okay, so come back over to this side. I'm sorry, there is a bin lorry outside making some noise. So from here, hop into the water and find this tunnel. Hop out and climb the ladder. You may have already spotted this health piece high on the ledge. Here it is. I missed. Gosh darn. I'll loop back round. There we go. Okie dokie, so now from here I'm going to get another power up, an energy power up and a glyph, and they are both inside the lair. I know. So there are enemies still inside here, don't forget. They don't disappear once you defeat the boss. Okay, so it is slightly easier just because we now have the projectile. Awesome. Okay. Come on. Let me get you. Got him. Cool beans. So, find the door, follow it round to find the door. And we're climbing the rooftops again, so don't forget this is the starting point, because we want to actually get into the main, well, not the main lair, but we want to get inside. So you're doing exactly what you did the first time you made it into the lair. I feel as though I sound really deep today. I've got a few days off, so I'm probably just in my lazy holiday mode. Got my lazy voice on. Okay. So just run straight on in, jump down, climb up. Okay. So when we were in here before, we activated the fan, so you can use the fan just to glide up quickly to a ledge, but I'm not very good at doing that, so I'm going to do it the longer way. So just shift and move the pipes. And sneak along if you're not very confident on thinner ledges. Dun 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 dun. Dun dun. Dun 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 dun. Okay. And here's the portal. And last time I was here, I wanted to show you the pipes move as I shifted. So I'm gonna try again and hope the camera angle does not change this time. There we go. How awesome was that? I think Raziel was mostly in that shot. Never mind. So now we've got this ladder right here. And a deleted part, I mentioned all the deleted areas. And later on in the game that got deleted, you can come back in here and climb, or go higher, climb higher. So I think the previous walls that looked like they were deleted, you do stuff there and that makes the air pressure even higher. And you can possibly glide straight up into what appears to be a hole straight up there. That's just a theory, don't know if it's true. That's just my thought. But anyway, find this. Where is it? My game is so dark and I don't know why. Here it is, oh my god. I will definitely sort that out on the editing. So you've got a blocked path, but just use your projectile to shoot it. Okay, and you've got an energy piece, an energy upgrade increase, super duper. So I believe that's the third one. And to get out of this gap again, you want to come just slightly higher and you can glide into the hole again. Okay, so just come back out. And at the end you can just jump straight on down. Cool beans. And there's a passage, here it is. So we've got a glyph down in this passage. We've got a sound glyph and there are enemies, just so you know. So just shoot him into the gap below. And you've got a target, so shoot that. Yep. There we go. So this glyph is pretty simple. It's got the puzzle part of it is the shifting. Okay, so shift to enter the area. And there are two wraiths in here. So just sort of rush to the portal. I mean, you can fight them. I just don't bother really fighting the enemies because I don't want to lose my Reaver. Okay. So on the wall here, you've got a stick, like a music beater stick, drumstick. And we're going to take that up to the top. So if you come back to the end of the room where you entered, hop onto the ladder. Okay, so we want to get to the other end of the room now, but this ledge in front is too far away. But if we shift, it will come closer. But if we shift, Razia won't be able to hold the stick. So we want to throw it into that space there. Just very carefully. Cool. Now we can shift. So glide on over and use the portal straight away. And now you can glide over to here and pick up the stick again. Okay, back to here. And making your way across, we can reach these ones without shifting. And we need to shoot a projectile at that. So what we need to do, we need to put the stick down, so just crouch and press action, so that we don't just lob the stick straight at that. And then shoot it. So a reminder for shooting is, for the PlayStation specifically, you press L2 and R2 at the same time, and he will look. You can look around. And you hold, for me, it's the triangle button. Hold it down and release. And that's how you shoot. So also, this ledge is too far away, so we will need to shift in order to reach it. So pick up your stick again and just throw it in there and shift. Cool. And the wraiths don't really bother you while you're higher up, so you're pretty safe when you're on them ledges. And then shift back, look for your stick. Where did it land? Awesome stuff. And here's the bell. So just come up to the bell, press action, and it'll whack it one. So we don't want the stick, so just lob it over there and collect your sound glyph. Well, bear with me. Apologies, that was the sound of my laptop dying. It's okay now though. So, again, I will do a demonstration. Sound glyph. So that sort of makes enemies stumble around and be like, ah, my ears! Why would you do that? Basically, they don't like the sound. But from here, just leave the exact same way, whoops, that we entered through the gate. So now I'm going to show you the way out if when you're doing this boss area to start with, and you fall into the pit and end up coming through this area. So I didn't show that before, but you want to come round to this way. It just, how dare you? He hit me. Okay. Nom nom nom. See what happens when you hit Raziel. So we came from that way. So up there is the glyph. Follow this around. And so if he fell before activating all of the pipes and you couldn't glide up again, you will have to come out this way and just make your way back in. Kind of annoying. But anyway, here we are in the main area where we were climbing the rooftops. And you want to find the portal. If you can't find it, just keep following the wall around and you'll eventually come to it. So now we're done in the lair area, and there is an enemy in here. Just a warning, don't let him scare you. You can probably hear him, hear his feet shuffling about. These Zephanim have weird sounds when they move. Anyway, the two enemies I killed over here, I'm now going to have respawned because there's, if I like burnt them, if I had the Fire Reaver, I believe if I didn't eat their souls, then they would not respawn. Because they'd still be there all burnt up. But anyway, you want to shift to be able to leave. And now I'm going for another glyph, and it is the worst glyph. I'm not going to shift back because you just hop down here and you've got a gate. Yeah, this area to get the glyph is worthy of an actual boss dungeon. So I am now, can't shift, I need a soul, and then I'll shift back. There we go. And now just follow the passage. At one point you will come to a big open area, but there's nothing there, just keep going straight forward to the next passage. Just here, so just find the next passage there. And you know that you're in the correct area because you'll get a bit of a cutscene. But the enemies in this area, actually, let me just point out this tunnel right here. This only leads to a warp gate, so I'm just gonna go ahead and activate that. But the enemies in this area are the ones that shoot projectiles, and they are the strongest and fastest and most aggressive, because they are the offspring of the one brother that was not featured in this game. So it would have been the last brother that would have been the hardest. But he didn't get a feature in this game, unfortunately. But it's nice that they put the offspring in and around in the game. Just in certain areas, not in all of them. Anyway, as you come out the tunnel, there is this weapon here. I know I've got the Reaver, but I'm just gonna grab this stick. Stick to the wall as well. Keep to the wall, because you may have just seen an enemy who might see you. Okay, so just hop out and hop up here. So the enemy is there, and he's not seen Raziel, so you can easily just throw the stick at him. Now come to this side so you can hop up. Oh no, well I'm definitely not going to get that soul. So if I was to take the stick out of him, if I didn't get the soul, he would come back to life because I didn't get the soul. Does that make sense? Okay, so this side, just hop up to here and then you can easily glide over to here. So I'm not going to bother getting that stick, the weapon, but I am going to do this to get fire. So now you can shoot a projectile of fire, which is awesome. It's going to be the easiest thing in this area, just because these enemies are annoying. But you do have another stick there, so that's lucky. So next, straight up here. Follow the passage. Just be wary of enemies. Shoot fire, there we go. I won't bother collecting his soul because I've got full health. Okay, so I've got him as well. This is why the Fire Reaver is the best. Now just glide over to here. There's another enemy in there somewhere. There he is! So it's good that the Reaver homes in on this. So I've got a feeling I'm not going to do too well today on this area, just because my image is for some reason really dark. So I don't understand why it's become dark today. Anyway, just follow the path round until you get to the door. So here there's two sections we need to do. We need to go through that door right there. And the end result is the door just there, so we need to do other things before going to that door. But it's not bothered to show what we need to do. So there's an enemy just there, so be aware of that. Oh, my neck just cracked something fierce. Anyway, come down to where you shot this guy. I'm going to go through this door first. So if you need a weapon, you've got these two sticks on the wall. There and there. So sometimes there are enemies lurking behind the corner. Okay. Can't see too good down the corridors. Oh, that's alright, we're in this room. So I think that guy's just heard Raziel because he turned very suddenly. Just want to do your best at shooting your projectiles. Seriously, don't want to lose my Fire Reaver. So don't forget, if you shoot a projectile at the same time they shoot a projectile, it sort of blocks the projectile, which is awesome. So, goal here is you've got a crank on the wall there, and this round thing that Raziel is standing on will spin around, and there's bits of fire on the wall. You can see right above the crank there's a pole with a bit going up that will produce a flame, and there's various of them around and about. So here we want to light all the flame things, but we don't want the round thing spinning around. So hop all the way up here and just find this block and give it a shove. Push it down to the bottom. So that is already lined up to be pushed into that space. So firstly, before you push that, you do need to use the crank. So there we go, there's the fires lit. So I don't fully understand this puzzle, like the idea of having the fires lit but not having this thing spinning around. But just give this a shove. Whoops, come on. Push, push, push. There we go. Oh, you know what? That seems to be timed. The fires have gone out. So I'm going to have to do it again. Just pull the block out. And use the crank again. Okay. Come on. Raziel. Okay, that's done it. So the flames on the walls are still lit. You see, they come all the way down here as well. Okay, so if you had that guy's soul that was straight out here, just be aware that he might still be right out here. No. So that's good. So now, from here, I don't think I can shoot that guy. I just saw a guy. Nope, he's too far away. Okay, I got him. So I hate these guys so much. So don't forget, that door is the end goal. We can't do anything there yet. So just turn around and you've got these platforms. Enemy over there. So hop your way along, and don't forget, if you do go in the water, your Reaver will be extinguished. You won't have the fire. Okay. Also, I've noticed the guys wearing the black clothes instead of the red clothes, they are harder to defeat as well. Where am I? Can't remember. Follow around. Oh, here we are. So, that guy right there who has seen me, you can't shoot him from here because of the railing. So annoying. So I don't want to lose the Reaver, and I don't... Oh god, the cutscene. I might just ignore him. But from here, the destination is straight down. I'll just ignore him. We will bump into him again though. Where? Oh no! What a bumhole. Where is he? You see, these guys stabbing him in the back. But I've collected his soul and he's disintegrated and yes, he is gonna come back now. Okay, so this area doesn't make too much sense. Especially when they give you funny looking flybys for no reason. It just makes it confusing. So, these gates are open, but the ones ahead are not. So, I'm going to shift. That will open the gates, and also I won't have to deal with that enemy. But now I've got my Reaver back. As soon as I shift, I won't have any fire, though, unfortunately. And here is the portal. And a door straight ahead, and as soon as you shift there will be enemies, so I'm just gonna bolt straight to the door. Okay, you ready? Steady. Go. Cool. So there should not be an enemy here. I could be wrong. I am wrong. I will use the best one, which is the fire glyph. And that's how that happens. How it happens, how that goes. How it's done. I think that's what I'm trying to say. Okay, so this room is a bit odd. We've got fans over in that corner that we need to activate, and to do that we need to fill this with water, but we need to put these blocks into place on this pipe first. So the first thing to do is the blocks and then activate the water, which will in turn activate the fans. Okay, so this block is gonna need flipping over, I think. Yep, here we go. Okay, so that is in place. And this one will need a flipping round to the correct angle as well. Okay, so once they're in place and you fill the gap of the pipe, just follow the pipe round over here and you will find this wheel. Okay. So come round to where we activated the fans. Okay, so over in this corner, this is tedious. So you want to just hop down and do your glide, but hold down the R2 button to glide to the next bit of words. So that is annoying. So from here at the highest point you want to climb up to here, and that was actually the second part of the puzzle. I said there's two parts, walk through that first door, and that was the second one. So now we can go through the last door and claim, well, not claim straight away the glyph, but that's the intention. So follow the path. I'm stuck in a camera angle. Oh. Okay, so I believe you need to... Oh yeah, I used a glyph. So you can collect the sparklies, because I don't usually use glyphs. So I forget to collect the sparklies, but they put your health, your energy back up, don't forget. So jump down on the furthest gaps. I'm just going to take this stick just for good measure. Comes through here. I'm going to sneak because I know there's an enemy. Oh well, I don't care. Don't even care. I don't think he's seen me. He saw me that time. I don't have to deal with him, but I will because he hit me the first time. So that's serve him right. So now you're heading straight back up. Don't forget there is an enemy at the top of the stairs. I believe these ones are Turalim. I said stairs, it's not stairs. But there was that one enemy I didn't get. So he'll be here somewhere. There he is. Bumhole, he got me. Just ignore him. So now, coming out the way you came, to the watery area. So now we have lit the lighthouse. I did not really think to mention that that's the goal here. But the lighthouse is lit and it's going to give us a hint of what we're doing now. So this is a helpful angle. So there is where we need to be. That door I said is the last place once we've done everything. That's where we're heading. So hop over these. Come on, hop up here, and because I didn't eat that guy's soul, he is dead. He's not respawned. So that's fabulous. There's an enemy in here somewhere. It is very dark. Where am I going? There is an enemy somewhere. I'll just use the fire again. Actually, let's use a new one because I've got the fire on the wall which I can quickly grab. Let's use the stone glyph. So that's frozen him. Grab this. Start attacking him. Awesome. I didn't get my reaver back. Oh, I did, there it is. I was holding the stick, so I couldn't see the reaver. So this is what the light from the lighthouse is doing. It's shining through the hole in the wall. And it's not easy to actually figure out what to do next, because we've done what we need to do, but where's the glyph? But you notice it shines every so often. So you actually want to shift when it's shining through the wall. So there we go, shift, and that's it. So I'm gonna shift to the material realm before I pick that up, just so I can do a demonstration. This is the light glyph, you may be able to guess. Okay, so this one is also a fantastic one to use for instant death for the enemies. Because obviously they don't like the light, so it burns them up. How awesome is that? So now we have 38 energy. I believe there is one more energy upgrade hanging around somewhere. And once we get another glyph, I think just one more glyph? Yeah, one more space for a glyph. That will put us up to a 52 energy. And I've just noticed Raziel is looking to one side, so that means there's an enemy behind this door. So just quickly shoot him into the water. And now we can actually just leave, so just find the... I don't know, what are we looking for? The warp gate. So back... Oh my goodness, where was that guy? Trying to shoot me. We're trying to find the warp gate so that we can leave and get out of Dodge. See, this is the most annoying glyph to actually find. So here we are, just hop straight into the water. Well, that's not water, but... Here we go. And then find the tunnel that will lead us to the warp gate. There it is. So that's it for part 5. I hope it's not been too boring because we've not had any story. But next time we will definitely be fighting the next brother. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Take it easy, guys. I forget where I'm going.